we have just found the direction for sines of two lines, right? Of when two points are given. These are sines and cosines. Now, what happens if I multiply the direction cosine by P3? That will become direction ratio. This is not. So, if I multiply L by P3, this gives me A. M into PQ will be Y2 minus Y1. M into PQ is Z2 minus Z1. So you understand? I do not have to take the trouble of finding out direction ratios many a times, direction cosines many a times, because I can just keep on subtracting their coordinates and I'll get the direction ratio. If the direction ratios of two lines are the same, they are parallel. They will be parallel. Do you understand that? They have to be parallel. Because what happens, just try to understand. If you have got a vector A is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, then A1, A2, A3 are actually its direction ratios. A1, A2, A3 are direction ratios. A1, A2, A3 are direction. Then if this, then A1, A2, A3 are direction ratios. You have doubts? You may have doubts. You should have doubts actually. See, A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap. We are dealing with vectors, with free vectors, so they are shiftable. So I shift them parallel to themselves and bring their tail to origin. When their tail is at origin, that means their head. Okay? If I draw those three planes through the head, one parallel to the XY, one parallel to the XY, another parallel. A1 upon mod A is equal to L, A2 upon A is M, and A3 upon A is M.
Okay, it is M. So what happens if I decide to multiply the L by A, and A is what? The length of the vector. Length of the vector is what? What is A? A is root over A1 square plus A2 square plus A3 square. We get the point? So what happens? What happens is, if I multiply A by L, so AL is A1, AM is A2, AN is equal to A3, and it is these which are the direction ratios. So this is A, this is B, this is C. So now you understand why A1, A2, A3 are direction ratios. So whenever you are given a vector, their ijk coefficients are actually representing the direction, they are representing the direction ratios. Okay, they are representing the direction ratios. Now we are given a question which asks us to prove that the three points, question 5, what is that? The three point, prove that the three points A, what are the points?
2, 3, -4.
2, 3, -4. B,
1, -2, 3.
1, -2, 3. And C,
3, 8, -11.
3, 8, -11 are collinear. So, if their direction ratios are the same, they are parallel. Now, let me finish this off. Now, if I have a vector that is parallel to itself, okay, then a vector that is parallel to this is represented as B is equal to lambda A, is it not? So any vector B which is a scalar multiplied by a vector is either a vector in that direction or in the opposite direction. So it is obviously parallel, at least it is parallel. Parallel or anti-parallel? Strictly speaking, parallel or anti-parallel. Okay. So if this vector B is B1 I cap plus B2 j cap plus b3 k cap, then it is equal to lambda times a1 I cap plus a2 j cap plus a3 k cap. Okay. Now what are the direction ratios of these? They are b1 b2 b3, and what are the direction ratios of this vector? Lambda A1, lambda A2, lambda A3. And since the vectors are equal, these are also equal, though equal sign is not used vertically, still I am using it. Okay? So, no, you understand that is fine, but don't use it formally. Okay? So if that is equal to this, it means what? What does it mean? A1 multiplied by, see, A1 itself is the direction ratio. A1, A2, A3 are direction ratios of this. You have multiplied it by another constant. So it is still the direction ratio of this vector. Still a direction ratio of that vector. Why? Because direction ratios are infinite. 1, 2, 3 is also direction ratio, and 2, 4, 6 is also direction ratio, and 3, 6, 9 is also direction ratio. I multiplied by 2 and I multiplied by 3. Okay, so it can take any value. So they still remain the direction ratios, do you see? And whenever the direction ratios are the same, the vectors are parallel or anti-parallel, okay? And lines are nothing but vectors without directions, right? Directionless vectors. So that's why there is a correspondence between the 3D and the vector that you have studied, okay? So you understand one, you understand the others. So if I subtract this, I'm trying to find the direction ratio. I'm not interested in direction cosine, okay? Because even if the direction ratios are equal or proportional, the lines will be parallel. You understand? So let me find out the direction ratio here. So direction ratio, I do 2 minus this. So direction ratio of, is not vector, direction ratio of AB is 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus minus 2, 5, minus 4 minus 3, minus 7. You could have subtracted this from this also, it would have made no difference. You just would have got a negative number of this. No problems. So direction ratio AB is that, and what is the direction ratio of BC? So I do this. So I do minus 2, minus 10, minus 14.
Plus 14.
Now see. Do I get this by multiplying minus 2 into this?
Yes, sir.
See, if this is the direction ratio and I keep 3 minus, I have subtracted this from that. 3 minus minus 11, right? So if this is direction ratio, this is also the direction ratio. Why? Because it is already, it is direction cosine multiplied by some constant. I have multiplied by some other further constant. Makes no difference. Why? Because we said it will remain a direction ratio as long as you multiply the direction cosine by any number. But that number should be multiplied to all the direction cosines evenly. Okay. So if I multiply this by minus 2, see, this is already a direction ratio. That means I have already multiplied the direction cosine by some constant. And come here. I can further multiply it by some other constant and it will still remain a direction ratio. And the moment the direction ratios are constant, so same, it becomes the lines become parallel. Or the direction ratios are proportional. You understand why? Because if they are proportional, it means I can find out a constant which when multiplied to one of them will lead me to the other one. So we do not insist on their equality, we also say their proportionality will work. So here what had happened? B1 is equal to lambda A1, B2 is equal to lambda A2, B3 is equal to lambda A3. So B1 upon A1 is equal to B2 upon A2 is equal to B3 upon A3 is equal to lambda. So it means that if the direction ratios are proportional, even then the lines are parallel. Okay? Therefore, lines are parallel if DRs are proportional. Okay? They are proportional. You could have also found out 1 upon minus 2. 5 upon minus 10 would have been 1 by minus 2. And minus 7 upon 14 would again have become equal to minus 1 by 2. So that too would have settled the issue. We understand that. Simple.